Okay, welcome back to Let Us Learn to Lead video series on free open source software designed by M. Srinivasan, Training Associate Mathematics, Kendra Vidyalaya Sangathan, Zonal Institute of Education and Training, Mumbai. Self-learning contents in video form on GeoGebra Dynamic Mathematics software is presented at this video series. To view the contents, you may join Google Classroom by using the class code 73AUMBO. In this video, you will learn designing a worksheet to visualize a cube. For preparing this video lecture, I used Windows 10 operating system, GeoGebra 5.0, a free open source software, and free open source screen recorder software. Let us start. Let us try to visualize what type of worksheets we are going to design. We are going to design a worksheet to visualize a cube. A cube is a three-dimensional space in which all the faces are equal dimension. We'll try to show the cube to the children and how many faces, how many vertices, and how many edges a child can come and rotate it and visualize it, visualize the cube. And not only that, a child can change its base also, and the side also, he can change it and he can visualize it. Not only that, we will tell them that how to calculate the total surface area, how to calculate the volume. And not only that, we will try to tell them that what do you mean by the diagonal of the cube by changing, and they can visualize the diagonal also. And not only that, they can visualize the net of this cube also. What is the net of this cube? They can visualize it. Okay, well, let us try to design this dynamic worksheet from scratch. For that, I have taken GeoGebra Classic 5 worksheet, where I have taken a geometry view. I think I can take it directly a geometry view. And in the options, I'm going for rounding off to one decimal place and labeling of new points only. Okay, now we can have start with the heading. We can have cube. Okay, we can define the cube to the children. It's a three-dimensional shape in which all the faces are in square shape and with equal dimensions. All are same squares. Okay, now how to do it? For that, we need one slider. The slider, you can call it as either side or you can call it as A, whatever you want. Let us have it as 1 and let us have it up to 10 and with increment as 1. It's left to you. I am keeping it as always an integer, natural number, whatever we call. Okay. Go to this line segment with the given length. Just to touch it. And remember, we can have directly a square from this GeoGebra, but I am using this slider to have a different squares with the different sides, nothing more than that. Okay, now I will touch it. It will ask what is the length you want. I will keep it as small a, so that when I move this, this also moves. Now to draw a square, no need to do anything because you are having a direct square option over here, that is the regular polygon. For touch this A, touch this B, it will ask how much vertices you want. We want 4 vertices, therefore okay. Now you got a square automatically. Now you see it is going on changing, the square is going on changing. Go to this view, go to this 3D graphics. Okay, in the 3D graphics already I have removed this plane, everything I have removed, therefore you are getting it directly now. Okay, now in that, go to this pyramid, go to this extrude to prism, simply touch it, it will ask what is the height. Therefore, for that we need the height. Remember, for this height is also A, therefore that you have to remember. Okay, extrude to prism, therefore extrude to prism, then touch it, it will ask the height. Here also you put small a. Okay, wherever you are putting it, you have to put it as small a. Okay, just okay. Now you got a cube now. Okay, fantastic cube you got. See, you got the cube. Okay, now you can go on exploring it now. Now you can tell what is the side of cube. Okay, it is actually from the object property. You can have it as a small a. Okay, it is small. Now we can go on exploring the formulae. Okay, first formulae is total surface area. Okay, the formula is 6 into side square 6. In the symbol, you can have this multiplied by side. From the symbol, you can have basic symbol square, side square. Okay. From this view, go to this input bar. Okay, it will open now. Now you can type now TSA or S, whatever may be, is equal to 6 multiplied by small a square. Remember, whenever you are typing anything, suppose if the color is not changing, suppose you see the change of the color is a is now blue, which means that a is already there. Otherwise, it will ask you to introduce it to GeoGebra. Therefore, 6 into a square. Okay. Therefore, now you can go for announcing that. I think this TSA, we can put it in this 3 dimension. Anywhere you can put. Both are one at the same. Okay, from the object, I think just now I have put TSE. Okay, it is 150. Very simple. 6 into 25. Before you got it as 150. Or you can put the total surface area over here. Well, now we can go for the declaring the formula for volume to the children. Therefore, volume is equal to side the whole cube. Or from the symbol, you can have this basic symbol, cube is here. Okay, now the child can understand what is the volume. Okay, now again in the input bar, capital V is equal to A power from this alpha A cube. Very simple. Therefore, you enter. Okay, go back to this and then again go for this volume is equal to from the object you have to take capital V. Okay, 125 is actually 5 cube. Therefore, it is 125. Therefore, when I am moving it to 6, when I am moving it to 7, when I am moving it to 8, when I am moving it to 9, and so on. Very highly interesting. At 6, actually, you see both the total surface area and volume are the same, because 6 into 6 square is nothing but 6 cube. Highly interesting. Now, here you see this A, I have taken it as in the form of increment 1. You can change the increment. Okay, now sometimes the children may be interested to know about the net of it. It's very simple. Again, go for this 3D graphics, come back to this net and then simply touch it. Okay, now you got one new slider. This slider will give you the net, or you can move it and then show the net to the children. What is the net of this cube? Therefore, in this worksheet, the child can understand, they can come and visualize it. They can come and visualize their cube and they can understand that what is the surface area of the cube and what is the volume of the cube and so on, they can understand. But it is a highly interesting worksheet. What you can do is, in this worksheet, you can right click it. You can right click and then you can have this navigation bar, so that from step number 1, 2, 3, you can explain to the children what is the cube, how it has come, what is the total surface area, what is the volume and so on, you can explain it to the children. But it is a very highly interesting worksheet where a child can visualize a cube and know about what is the parts of the cube and how many vertices it has and so on. You see, now one more thing you can have, the cube, how many faces are there, how many vertices are there, that also you can put it over here. Okay, this you can put it and then you can ask the children to check it out. Okay, how many cubical faces are there, how many vertices are there, how many edges are there, you can find out. Thank you, let us learn to lead.